Hey guys, it's Kim and welcome back to my channel. So today I am going to be doing a video giving you tips on where to travel to when you're going to Japan. So last time I uploaded a video on how to learn Japanese, and pretty much what I'm doing is I have an email set up where you guys just send me questions or topics on anything that you want and I will make a video out of that. So if you guys have any questions or topics that you want to ask me, then send me an email at kim.questions@gmail.com or otherwise comment in the comment box below and let me know what you want me to make. So let's get started on the video. So today I am going to be talking about the places to visit in Japan. I've received so many emails about people just wanting to travel to Japan but they don't know where to go. So today I'm going to tell you the places that I personally really enjoyed. Number one, Tokyo. Obviously if you're going to Japan, you probably would want to go to Tokyo, the capital city of Japan. And I love Tokyo because it's just so much you can do there. Whether you love shopping, sightseeing, eating, you can do all of that in Tokyo. Shopping, if you love shopping, definitely check out Shibuya. Shibuya has so many shops there, and if you like Japanese fashion, definitely check out Shibuya 109. There's just so much you can buy in Shibuya 109. It's mainly just Japanese fashion. It's more on the expensive side, so more of the branded Japanese stuff, but obviously there are sales and depends on the brand. Sometimes you can pick up like some really cheap bargains. I've picked up a lot of bargains there before. My second favorite place to shop in Tokyo is Harajuku. If you want more cheaper items, I found that Takashita Dori, which is like the main street in Harajuku, they have a lot of shops that sell cheaper items that are very similar to the fashion in Shibuya 109. So if you kind of want to buy like, I guess, knockoffs, then go to Harajuku. There are so many shops that sell cheap items. There's also a Liz Lisa on the Takashita Dori, so it's on the same street. Also, there is also Bodyline, so if you guys like cosplay kind of things, you can buy cosplay stuff at Bodyline. And yeah, there's just so much on that one street. Third favorite place for me to shop is Ikebukuro. So Ikebukuro is kind of like a city inside a city, but go to Sunshine City. Sunshine City is like a big shopping mall, and they have a lot of stores that sell shoes, clothes, all that stuff. So if you want to like look for Japanese fashion, definitely check them out. Obviously, if you don't want to look for Japanese fashion, then you do have a lot of choices like, you know, Zara, Forever 21, H&M, they're all in Japan as well. They have all those stores in Shibuya actually, so you can actually find them in Shibuya. Not hard to find at all. Fourth place I recommend shopping is Shinjuku. Shinjuku is so busy and I always get lost. I actually don't go to Shinjuku much, but there's a lot of shopping you can do in Shinjuku. There's just shops everywhere. You can go into the little shopping malls like Ulta, and you can, yeah, just walk around the place. There's just so many buildings there. If you like all the anime, manga, like figurines, like anime figurines, stuff like that, go to Akihabara because you'll find so much of that stuff there. That place is like the electric town of Japan, so you can buy all your anime goods there. I don't know much about Akihabara to be honest because I don't go there much, but there are so much anime things you can buy. You can buy cosplay costumes there. Sightseeing in Tokyo, there is quite a lot of sightseeing that you can do in Tokyo. So I don't really sightsee much in Tokyo because I like to shop and hang out with friends. But there are a lot of things you can see, like there's a Tokyo Tower, which I haven't been before, but apparently it's really nice. There's also the Asakusa Sky Tree, which is just new, was finished building maybe 2 years ago. I haven't been there myself, but I went just in front of it because the line was just too long to go up. But apparently it's really, really nice, and I was just standing outside. They've built like a massive shopping center around the area as well, which is really beautiful. Temples is something that you can also see in Japan. So there is a huge temple near Harajuku. It is in the Yoyogi Park area. So there's a massive one there which you can go to. Also, Asakusa has a temple that you can also check out as well. I've been there before, it's really nice. Also, there are two theme parks which I really recommend you go to if you're in Tokyo. Tokyo Disneyland and Tokyo DisneySea. I personally love DisneySea more. I find that DisneySea is more for adults and just more rides that adults would enjoy. I can spend the whole time there, it's just so much fun. Fireworks every day, awesome food there. And yeah, just a lot of attractions that are just really awesome. Disneyland, it was fun, but I found that I got bored really quickly. So about half a day I'd spend there and then I just get bored because there's not much to do. It was still cool, it was still fun. But if I had to choose between Disneyland and DisneySea, definitely DisneySea. Okay, let's go into another city now. Another city that I would definitely recommend you go to is Osaka. So Osaka is about, like, if you're going by bus, it's about 8 hours by the Shinkansen, which is the bullet train. It's about 3 hours or so. or if you fly there, it's about, you know, an hour and a half away. Some shopping places in Osaka. So my favorite place to shop is probably in Umeda. Umeda is like the city central of Osaka. So you can get there by Osaka Station by JR or to Umeda Station if you're going by all the other private lines. It's exactly the same spot. And there's so much shopping you can do there. The thing that's different about Osaka is that there are a lot of underground malls. So you might get lost a lot in Osaka because that's what I found, what happened to me. But there are a lot of underground malls you can go check out. There's also a massive store called HEP 5 that is kind of like the Osaka version of Shibuya 109, I think. So there's all the brands that you can get in Shibuya 109. So whatever you see in Shibuya 109, you can find it in HEP 5 as well. Another place that I love shopping in is Tennoji. Tennoji is also like a Shibuya 109 area as well, I'd say. So it's just got so many shopping malls. There's Mio, which is one of my favorite malls. It's pretty much the same as Shibuya 109. As you guys know, I love Shibuya 109, so I like shops like that. Also, there is a mini Shibuya 109 in Tennoji. It's not that big though, so it's got a few stores in there, not many. Also, there are a lot of cool like shoe shops and then little makeup shops around that area as well. The third favorite place for me to shop is Shinsaibashi. Shinsaibashi is like kind of like a Harajuku but cheaper. Like there's so many cheap shops. There are a lot of shoe shops there that sell shoes for like $10 each. So I like to buy a lot of shoes there because it's so cheap. It's only like $10 a pair. So yeah, I definitely like going to Shinsaibashi if I want to pick up a cheap bargain. Also, Shinsaibashi is like a really long strip. It's like, I don't know how many k's it goes on for, but it's a really, really long road and it's just full of shops. So you can spend the whole day there. Just sightseeing in Osaka? There's actually so much sightseeing you can do in Osaka. So for example, you can go to the Umeda Sky Tower, Sky Tree, and I've actually been there. It's really amazing. I've been there twice. It's pretty much like you go all the way up in the building. It's like, ooh, I can't remember how many floors, like 60 floors, 70 floors? I'm not too sure, I can't remember. Once you go up there, it's freezing if you're going in winter, but it's so beautiful. You see all the lights of Osaka around you. You can just walk around the area and the floor is like lit up with all these starlights. So definitely go if you can. It's really cheap to go up. It only costs you like $7 for the entry fee. And you can just spend as much time as you want up there. You probably don't want to spend too much time if it's really cold, but definitely go and check that out because it's really beautiful. And I really recommend you go at night because it's much nicer at night. If you go during the day, it's just concrete. So definitely go at night. So that's when you see all the lights. Also, if you like to go to aquariums, there is the Osaka Aquarium. I've been there twice and that's really nice as well. There's like a massive, massive tank. And it just circles around so you can walk all the way down kind of thing and you can see all the fishies and stuff. It was just really nice there and the area is actually really nice itself. So definitely check out the aquarium if you like looking at fishes and stuff like that. The other sightseeing places that you can go to, there's also the Osaka Castle, which is like, it's meant to be an old castle, but then they recently renovated everything in it. And to be honest, I would say give this one a miss because I didn't find it very interesting myself. When you go in there, everything's pretty much new and you can read a lot about the history. So if you're someone like me who's not that interested in history, then maybe give this one a miss. But if you really love all the history stuff, definitely go give that a visit. If you love your movies, if you love Harry Potter, Hello Kitty, definitely go to Universal Studios Japan. I've been there once and it was actually really fun. Except the day that we went, it was a bad day because half of the rides were closed. But if you really like that stuff, definitely go. It is a lot of fun. There's so much merchandise you can buy, like a lot of Hello Kitty stuff. And they recently opened up their Harry Potter area as well, which I haven't been to yet, so I'm going to probably visit that next time I go to Japan. But if you guys have time, definitely go to Universal Studios. It is so much fun there. If you have time and if you want to check out the temples around Kyoto, definitely go from there from Osaka. I don't really recommend staying in Kyoto because there's not much to do there besides temples, but I think that you can get them done within 1 or 2 days. Kyoto is more like a day trip to me, so I would probably stay somewhere in Osaka and then take a train to Kyoto for a day. In Kyoto there's a massive temple called the Kiyomizu-dera, and that is just like a massive temple. I think there's a fee of $5 to get in. It is so big, you can just walk around there. There's still a lot of souvenirs there as well. There's also this thing called the Love Rock, so you have to close your eyes and walk from one rock to the other and touch them, and then apparently you get good luck or something like that. I don't know, but that was really fun to try. and it's just really beautiful. So I went during winter, and obviously there's no, you know, cherry blossoms and the trees are kind of dead looking, but it's still really beautiful. Another place that's not really a temple but it's really famous called Adachiyama, and this just has like a lot of tall trees everywhere. It's just awesome, like you just walk down this road and there's just all these trees, and yeah, it just looks really beautiful, so definitely go there if you can. And then there's also like a famous golden pavilion, if that's what you call it. It's called the Kinkakuji, and you can't really go in, well, you can't go inside it, so you just take photos from outside. So I've never been myself, but a few of my friends have gone and I've seen photos, it looks really beautiful. I think that it'll be something cool to see and probably something that I'd go to next time I'm in Kyoto. So if you like the more olden day Japan kind of things, definitely go to Kyoto, it is really beautiful there. If you want to go to see more sightseeing down in that kind of area, sort of-ish, you can go to Hiroshima. So Hiroshima is, I think it's about 2 hour train trip from Osaka. If you go to Hiroshima, obviously there's an atomic bomb dome there that you can have a look at. If you really enjoy that history stuff, I actually found it really fascinating, really interesting. Of course it's really sad, so don't expect to like kind of go there and come out being really happy. I thought the museum was really good, like it was so interesting, it had so many facts, it wasn't biased at all. Yeah, it was just really interesting to learn a lot of stuff there, and they had a lot of little artifacts there that was really interesting to see. You can see the atomic bomb dome yourself. Also, they built like a huge park, like a memorial park, and there's like a lot of paper cranes and stuff, so that's really fascinating to see. Okay, so another region that I loved in Japan is Hokkaido. Hokkaido is the most northern part of Japan. I love it so much there. It's probably one of my favorite places to go now. I went there for the first time this year and I fell in love with Hokkaido. So if you're in Hokkaido during the snow festival, definitely go to the snow festival. It's so much fun. They have this like massive park which they just put all of these like little stores, food, souvenirs, they build snow sculptures. It's awesome. Definitely go there if you are in Hokkaido during the snow festival. I find that the food is the best in Hokkaido. What you can do is that you can catch a train to Hokkaido from Tokyo, but it's going to take you a really long time. So I personally would again recommend you to fly. So I flew from Tokyo to Hokkaido. I think it took about 2 hours or so, and it cost me $100 both ways, and I flew vanilla air, so that was really good. I got a really good bargain, so keep checking those sales because you will find something that you will like probably. Sapporo is kind of like Osaka. Like, I find that there are a lot of underground malls. That's great because it's so cold outside anyway that you want to stay inside, but there is a lot of sightseeing places that you can actually visit and shopping as well. So shopping in Sapporo, I didn't really shop much in Hokkaido because I found that it was more of like a food place and more sightseeing area. So in Sapporo, there are a lot of shops though. They have the Pokemon Center there, they do have Liz Lisa, the Shibuya 109 stores, they have all that in Sapporo. Other than that, I didn't really go shopping anywhere else besides Sapporo. There's one thing I have to recommend you to do is go to a hot spring. It is amazing. Like, you might find it weird because you have to go in naked and you can't really wear a towel or anything like that. Like, you just go in wearing your birthday suit. So it was really weird for me at the start because I was kind of like, oh, I don't feel comfortable doing that. But seriously, it's amazing. So I went to one in Noboribetsu and it's like amazing. Obviously, it was separated male and female. And then once you walk in, when I walked in, I saw like, just, like girls just walking around naked and you were like, okay, well, I guess if everyone's doing it, then it's okay if I do it, right? Once you go in, it's amazing because it was winter at the time I went. Snow was falling down on me and I was sitting in this hot spring that's like, you know, obviously really hot, but it was amazing. Amazing experience. I can just sit there for like, well, you can't sit there for too long, but I sit there for like 15 minutes or so. So nice in there. I definitely recommend you go and experience that because you will fall in love with hot springs after that. So I'm definitely going back there again. And then also what you can do is just explore the mountains there. I found it beautiful there because you can explore mountains. There's so many nice like natural sights you can see as well, which is really great. And also there's a ninja theme park nearby which you can just catch a bus there to get to. It is quite nice, but it's quite empty. I think the time I went was just really bad because most of the stores were closed, but I think it'll be really fun if I went on the right day with like a lot of people there. So that's all for my tips on where to go in Japan. Hope you guys found it really helpful, and let me know where you want to visit the most in Japan if you haven't gone yet, and if you have gone to Japan, what's your favorite place? If you have more topics for me to talk about, it doesn't have to be Japan related, it can be anything like school, love, life, traveling, I don't know, anything you want. Send me an email to kim.questions@gmail.com or just post it in the comment box below. Whatever topic I get asked the most, I will do the video on that topic. So thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye!